Now, as we've been saying, Nelson Serrano's alibi is that he was holed up in an Atlanta motel with a migraine on the night of the murders.
Mr. Serrano proceeds to tell the detective that he was in Atlanta, Georgia, in a motel room at the La Quinta Inn with a migraine headache all evening.
All right, there was a gap of 10 hours on December 3rd when Serrano was not seen on motel surveillance tape, but when he did appear at 10:20 p.m., he could be seen drinking coffee. Is drinking coffee and sitting alone in a motel room common behavior for migraine sufferers? Dr. Alexander Mauskopf, director of the New York Headache Center, joins us with now some medical expertise. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
Let's begin with... Give us some foundation, some background here on migraine sufferers. I mean, someone who suffers from a migraine, how much forewarning do they have? Does it just hit you all of a sudden? Does it come on you gradually? Do you know when it's coming? And then how long do these things last?
Actually, anything can happen. You can develop a headache out of nowhere. You wake up with a severe migraine. Or you can have a gradual development. You can have a warning. So anything can happen. And migraine is a very debilitating illness. And it can disable you for a day, two, or even 3 days. And when you get a headache, many people do drink coffee as a remedy. Excessive amounts of caffeine actually make the headaches worse, but many people find relief from a cup of coffee and a couple of aspirins, and a drug like Excedrin, which many people take for their migraines, contains caffeine, aspirin, and Tylenol in it. So it's not an unusual behavior to be locked up in a room for a day and drink coffee.
All right, so far so good for this defendant when we're talking about,
yeah.
But it's a 10-hour period in this motel room, Lisa Bloom, and he's drinking coffee afterwards, so all of a sudden the coffee doesn't look that bad.
Right, and in fact, I've just been reading here in your book, Dr. Mauskopf, that a lot of headache remedies do have caffeine. Your book, What Your Doctor May Not Tell You About Migraines. So you are the guy because you have, in fact, written the book. But what about this, Dr. Mauskopf? Would somebody suffering from a migraine go 10 hours without eating, just lying there in a hotel room, without going out and getting something to eat?
It's very common. People get very nauseous and they don't feel like eating. They're throwing up, and it's not unusual at all. What is unusual is that if you're having a migraine to travel somewhere, travel actually can trigger a headache. So it's not unusual for a person to fly and then get a headache. So it's definitely fits the pattern of migraine headaches. The only unusual thing in this case is that the vast majority of patients with migraines are women, and as you get older, fewer and fewer people get migraines. Both women and men tend to lose their migraines as they get older. So the typical
at about what age, doctor?
Usually in the 40s and 50s, headaches tend to subside. And that's not to say that I have not seen patients in their 80s having migraines.
Okay, well, that's very interesting to me. Now, what about a history of migraines? Because we don't know whether this defendant has a history or not. We know that he claimed he had a migraine on December 3rd, 1997, but would you expect him to have a history once a month, once a year prior to that day?
Absolutely. The migraine is a disease of young age, so you can develop them later in life, but it's extremely unusual to start having migraines in your 40s, 50s, 60s. So if the prosecution... does its due diligence, they would look at medical records, and if the patient does have a very strong, long history of migraines, that fits the pattern. That could be a real event that took place.
Very interesting. All right, so Bruce Wenger, help us put this together for the defense. If you're defending Nelson Serrano, are you going to call a migraine expert like Dr. Mauskopf to talk about the symptoms that Nelson Serrano says he was feeling and how this would be consistent with the migraine sufferer?
I would do anything in my power to obviously help Mr. Serrano. Obviously, if Dr. Mauskopf or an expert as Dr. Mauskopf is, can come and testify to the symptoms and what Mr. Serrano alleges happened is accurate or consistent with migraine headaches, of course I'm going to call him. I will do everything within my power to defend him and to lead credence to his story.
Dr. Mauskopf, there's a couple of videotapes in this case, and we see the defendant prior to suffering this migraine at around 12:21 in the afternoon in the lobby. Looks like maybe he's looking at a map and having a discussion with the hotel clerk. And then there's a 10-hour gap. We see him again on the videotape with that cup of coffee in the lobby again having conversations with the clerk. So what I'm trying to figure out is the onset of all of this. in the beginning at 12:21 when he's in that lobby, and are you going to say, oh, all of a sudden I'm starting to feel a migraine and maybe whatever plans I had, I was going to cancel those plans and then do something else? Or is it a case where, you know, all of a sudden it's just going to hit him and then boom, you know, he's got to find the closest place where he can just lie down, turn off the lights, turn off the phone and just sit still?
Yeah, so that's very plausible, definitely plausible. But again, I would look at his prior history and look at the frequency of headaches that he's had in the past.
And the types of headaches you have in the past, Dr. Mouskop, are they consistent the way migraines hit migraine sufferers?
Yes. Once you have a certain pattern, usually you'll continue having similar kind of attacks. If he's never had a severe headache before that made him unable to function for a day, for the first time, this time, I would not buy that. But if he has a history of similar headaches in the past and he's taken medicine, especially if he has a record of prescription medications for his headaches, then it fits the pattern.
And the other thing, the other fact here that intrigues me a little bit is the fact that before this migraine and after this migraine, he's wearing the same clothes. Now, I'm sure there's plenty of ways to explain that.
Right.
But I'm just wondering, would it be, I mean, because I'm wondering how these things hit you. Does it hit you in such a way that, you know what, I'm suffering this migraine, I'm not even going to get into more comfortable clothes, I am just going to lie down and I can't move? Or is it that, you know what, I want to be as comfortable as possible and maybe that'll help relieve this headache?
Well, he was traveling. Maybe he had no other clothes to put on. So
that's a good point. He doesn't have
no jammies.
What, a t-shirt? I mean, don't most men wear a t-shirt under those business clothes?
Yeah, or I would take the jacket off. I would take the turtleneck off. I don't know if I'm going to go to bed, but I don't suffer from migraines. That's why I want to.
Yeah,
find
but you might put it back
doctor.
On when you go back down to the lobby if you don't have any other clothes. Hey,
that's
Dr. Mouskop, I was looking in your book at ways to get relief from migraines, cures, diet, magnesium, lying down. How about a Brazilian mistress? Would that be something that would help alleviate a migraine?
That's probably the best treatment.
That's the best treatment. Would you expect a guy suffering from a migraine to jump on a plane and go down to Florida, see his Brazilian mistress, and then jump on a plane and go back up to Atlanta on the same day?
Well, I don't think it's a medical question, really.
Well, I think the one thing that you did say that I think helps the defense here is you said that traveling, though, can help bring it on. And
yes.
This is a guy who was traveling. We know that he was just getting off a plane and had just traveled to Atlanta, so that would be consistent. Dr. Mouskop, thank you so much for joining us today. You answered a lot of questions that
thank
I've had for a couple
me.
Weeks here, and you've gotten rid of my headache.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My pleasure.